Breville design and manufacture small domestic appliances for the global market. So we differentiate ourselves through innovation. We don't just design or build appliances that look different. They have to perform better. They have to be more engaging. They have to be more reliable than any other appliance in the world. The journey for simulation started for us over 10 years ago. We looked at two of the leading flow and thermal packages, and we selected ANSYS through the benefits of having local support and the power of the package. It's expanded our capabilities, so not only in thermal but in fluids, and I think this is what's led to our ability to innovate faster. The key challenges with a product like the pizza oven, or the pizziola as it's known, is that it's the first benchtop appliance that can reach 400 degrees, so it can cook pizzas within 2 minutes. The key story of innovation for the pizza oven was to deliver true wood-fired performance in a benchtop appliance. So for us, the critical parts were to ensure that we could get the temperature where we needed it, when we needed it, and to ensure that the components and all the materials inside could survive the extreme temperatures. So we used the fluid and the thermal analysis packages to understand the heat and the airflow within the product, and stress analysis on the cooking surfaces to help us optimize strength and performance of our materials. Discovery Live is an important part of developing our concepts faster before we even get into the prototyping stage. So it gives us an idea of where we should be looking at for solutions, and it's a dynamic tool that's powerful and accurate. Traditionally, we've been a make, test, learn development facility. Simulation, though, is perfectly suited to helping us understand the problems that we face. And the significance is a reduction in costs, but also building better prototypes sooner. We can reduce the development of components from 3 months to less than 2 weeks. We look forward to continuing our work with ANSYS. We think that simulation will continue to form a huge part of our development iteration cycles. And I think it will just become a more intrinsic part of our work within the product design space.